Good morning, everybody. I'm going to use the clear Stampin' Die of the month for February. I got a 4x6 card blank, and I have a just piece of white card, and some say stamp first, then die cut. Some say die cut, then stamp. I'm going to stamp first and then die cut. That's what I usually do, but I've been trying to change the other way around. But with this, unless you're using a stamping platform, you want to stamp first, I think. If you're using a stamping platform, then you're okay to try the other way. But there. The ink I'm using is the Quick Dry Twilight Gray. See it on the stamp. All right, let's try it and see. Okay, let's see. Good. Turned out perfect. Okay, I'm gonna put this back. I'm just gonna stick it back in here for now. And now I'm gonna die cut. I will color it after I die cut. That way I haven't wasted the coloring if it doesn't die cut right. And so it comes on this weird plasticky paper. I'm gonna trim it. It has to go on here. So it looks like the die cut okay. I hope. we're gonna hope this is good. Could have gone over it this way a little bit, but it looks pretty good to me. So now we can color it. And I'm just just starting with that frame. No reason. Just am. Blue around this frame here. All right. Green on the stems. Just put a little bit of green on that ball, and I'll put some of the color on it too. Stems while I'm here. I'm not blending, just coloring in. Here's one I missed. Now I'm going to get the yellow and do the little I actually want that a different color. I have a different yellow here. Maybe this is brighter. All right. I'd be really doing this wrong, but look. Okay. I like the way them strokes look on there. I got real quiet, huh? Sorry about that. This pen is so dried out. I should have checked it before I started. Trying to get color down. I hope the other pen's not as dry. This is Oh, that's much better, and the colors are pretty close, so yeah. I'm gonna try the other end, and I'm just gonna that was so not the way to use these, but because it was so dry and I already had the color down. Well, that's not great looking, is it? Not looking so hot. That's all right. Look at the card put together. Sometimes when you're using these alcohol markers, you think it's looking bad, and once they've had a time, some time to, for the alcohol to kind of evaporate, then they end up looking better than you thought. I don't think that's gonna be anywhere near the case with this. But I did want to give you that information, especially if you're blending, then, you know, then it really is. You got to give it some time to evaporate. I'm gonna come back with some of the yellow. And just gonna do a little blend in. It's not gonna blend because they're different colors. But now if you're worried about getting the other color on your yellow, I'll show you what you do. As you can. It can. I don't know with these ones if it does with the Crafter's Companion ones, but I've seen it do it with other brands. Just come over and rub it until it is the color it's supposed to be, then you know you got it. Okay. So there we are. But that's pretty messy looking. Let me just getting that yellow to just kind of fix it up a little bit, see if this helps. think that's the best I'm getting out of it. Okay, so on the card front. Do we want to look at the picture that we got from them? Let's see what's on here. Oh, there isn't one. Huh. What about on the stamp? There really isn't one on that either. So. We're going to want some kind of background, and that's going to make a big difference. So this is going to probably be a Happy Easter. I'm trying to get this piece of paper by itself. I know it's not that thick. I know there's two pieces. There we go. Let's see. Yep, I think so. So we're gonna do this one, our base. I'm gonna make it smaller. There we go. Okay, so that's this one, right? Okay, and then I want yellow. Okay, so I'm gonna do what kind of border I want. And I want a pretty good border. So probably about there. And then I need to double it because I need that border all the way around, not just this side. So double it, and now cut this. And if you're worried about it, start out smaller and just, it's easier to take away than it is to add. Now seeing it like this, I want this on the bottom and the Happy Easter up here instead of. First, I originally thought I would put this on top and then Happy Easter, but now I'm thinking the other way. Okay. I get the fine glue. I use a fine glue because it's a thin paper. And the glue may make it want to ripple. So hopefully with the fine, it won't do it as bad. Okay. Make sure I got this in the right direction. Make sure that's going the right way. Okay, and this will go here. I'm thinking kind of like that. Maybe we'd want to do some, cut out some foliage from the other. I'm going to kind of bring it this side a little bit, this way. Then I'm gonna go with a little bit of this, a little bit of yellow, whoops. And a little bit of white. White paper to stamp on. Here we go. Piece of white paper to stamp on. Oh, I didn't get that straight at all, did I? Oh. Alright, let's do Happy Easter. Yes, look, good the first time. Love it. All right, and now to find the die. Is this the one or is this the one? For some reason, I'm thinking it's this one. Yep. Okay, so this is gonna go back on here. This. I could just put it straight here. But no, I don't care for that. So I'm gonna take a chance. And I'm just gonna glue it down to some yellow. And I'm gonna cut around it. See, I wish they gave us a shadow layer on these words, but I'll just be happy with what I got. If you're not doing a video, you could definitely wait for the glue to dry. Okay. And then after this, it's gonna go on there. Okay. I'll be happy there with that. The lid back on. I don't know. Let's try the green. First, I'll check it on a separate piece of paper. And looky here, yellow from the boots. Ooh, see, always do a separate piece of paper first and then check it. And I think that's gonna work with that green. So I'm gonna do that kind of offset over there. Maybe not the best choice to have done. Let's see. I don't want that sticking to something else, so let's cover it up. I was kind of thinking a butterfly, but there's no butterflies in here. There are. Dragonflies, but not the right color either. There are sprigs of foliage. No, I'm not finding anything pre-made, so. Guess it's gonna have to stay this way. I don't know. I should have centered it. All I guess, that's me. All right, everybody. Uh-oh. If you like my video, please hit the like and subscribe button. Thank you for joining me, and I hope you join me again. Bye-bye now.